is Matthew Brent.
My name's Mackenzie Fink.
What got you into theater, Matt?
When I was at Calavera Middle School, there was an exploratory wheel where we did four things, and one of them was theater, and that's how I was exposed to it, and I've taken it every year since.
For as long as I can remember, there's a video of me when I was 4 years old on stage for a church event. Like, just, I had some line or that I had to sing or say, so it's been a part of my life forever, and I love it.
Oh, it's a necessity. I know a ton of people that they don't feel comfortable in their normal classes, but they come to theater and...
It not only did it provide me an outlet for whenever I was stressed about anything, it gave me that time to be able to, like, take a break from all of my academics so that way I could focus on them more when I did return to them. You get introduced to so many people and just, it gives you such a well-rounded education.
And they love it.
Theater, me personally, it's brought me out of my shell. I used to be really shy and quiet. I'm still relatively shy and quiet. But theater helped me gain a confidence and an air I didn't have before.
And Jack Winans was my drama teacher, and he decided to do A Midsummer Night's Dream.
Born was actually during a Renaissance fair that
the first acting job we were conscious of was King Lear that we were doing at the Shakespeare Festival. We were about six, and we were providing percussion.
And I got to play Peter Quinn. We took it to a couple of festivals. We won a couple of festivals. One thing I've noticed.
I had a second family, and I was able to express myself creatively. And I think being able to connect to people, speak with people, meet people, different generations and different walks of life, come together and make something together.
Yeah, it's a way that people can creatively use their minds and help better understand life lessons that are sometimes presented in dramatic pieces.
Having outlets like that is useful for everyone, not even if you go into the arts, but in whatever profession you go toward, has fruits that go way beyond the arts.
If we didn't have theater to teach, then
oh my God, it is extremely important because we get so much from theater and different kinds of theater. We get cooperation, we get communication, we get literature. Tell a child to sit down and read a book, they may take to it, they may not. It's connecting with the literature, it's connecting with the characters and the stories that you read. You know, not all kids are natural performers, but if you can give them something to do that's kind of within their comfort level, then they'll start to break out of that, and they'll break out of their comfort level, and they'll try new things. Because I am completely unathletic. I was born a month premature, and that actually created a little bit of brain damage that affected my hand-eye coordination. And so, doing the puppetry and doing the arts, that was a way for me to get some attention that was positive attention. And so that was how I got to show this.
In Los Angeles, when I was young, they had a Shakespeare contest. And if you won, you would get a scholarship to the Royal Academy of Dramatic Arts.
Wow.
And I won, and my professor was John Barton, who's a very well-known Shakespearean actor. My roommate was Albert Finney.
Wow.
Then I came back to California and got a contract with a director who's been the Merchant of Venice to go to the Fred Miller Theater in Milwaukee. And that's where I met Craig Knoll. And Craig Knoll happened to be directing The Taming of the Shrew there. That was 1960. Education is important. I teach the MFA students. The biggest mistake that most people make with Shakespeare is they stress out words and have to say. So if you take a speech of Shakespeare and circle all the words and draw a line through it, you'll find out where the action of the speech is coming. That's what the audience understands. And most people don't know that.
My name is Alex Sandy, and I'm from Edinburgh, Scotland. And I've lived in San Diego for 60 years. So I'm working on an American accent.
Can you tell us what got you into theater?
Well, actually, I never done any theater until I was in my mid-50s. We were doing Brigadoon, which is a story of a village in Scotland appeared in every 100 years. Oh. So I became Major MacGregor, and I wish that I had taken this up earlier in life. And so after doing Polonius and Hamlet, I talked to a few people about forming a Shakespeare Society youth festival in Balboa elementary schools before. Well, that's just amazing. Because they don't teach elementary school rooms. So it's up to the teachers or the parents things. And, you know, like the little girl tonight who's nine, she's been performing since she was six. And when she first performed, I remember getting a report saying that even when she was off stage, she was in character.
That's awesome. Yeah, that's fantastic.
Yeah. So we're just so happy to encourage so many young kids.
Well, I'm happy I got you to be a part of this organization.
Well, we look forward to much in the future.
Please welcome.